Hey guys, my name is Alex. Today I will talk a little bit about Floowandereeze. You might ask, is Flounder still a good deck in the current meta? And the answer to that is probably no, but I think if you like and know the deck well enough, you can still do decent with it. An advantage of this deck is that nobody expects it, since everybody thinks that is completely dead. Therefore, it gets underestimated a lot. And also a cool thing is that nobody's freaking out when they see that you play Flounder. I played this deck yesterday at the regional in Cologne. We were 260 players, and I unfortunately lost on the bubble, which was totally fine, because in a few instances where I lost, it was totally on my part. I just misplayed a tiny bit, which cost me in the end, which, like I said, it's totally fine. But I didn't think it was the deck's fault, which is a good sign, I think. So let's get into the profile. So we play Flounder, so we play the 3 Rubina, 3 Eagle, 1 Stree, 1 Toucan. I play 40 cards, and yeah, it sucks when they get banished face down, but sometimes it be like that. It's not worth it playing more of these. Then I play 2 Empen and 1 Snarl. Empen is the best card. It gets into engine, but you can also play 3 of this, but then you need you don't have space to cut something else, so you have to play 2, which is fine. Snarl is really, really good against Sprite and Kashtira especially. I expected a lot of Sprite and Kashtira, therefore I tuned my deck to counter these decks the most. Especially in the main deck, and it worked out really, really good since I played mostly against Sprite and Kashtira yesterday. Then you also play like the other big birds, the Mega Riser and the Apex Avian. So basically, before this, you played like 3 birds and 2 statues, and basically this is the same ratio, but yeah, 5 big birds is enough. Then 3 map, 3 quick spell. This card is absolutely broken. You can do so many things with this card. Just one of this. I tested a version where I played 3 Empen and 3 of this, because they both are not once per turn and they clear board so easily. But I think having another like other non-engine cards than this like engine or semi-engine card is better. So played only one. I missed once, maybe a second one. I think you can play either ratio and it's totally fine, but one is definitely mandatory, and the one trap. The counter trap is not that great because it loses a heart to each book and blowouts in this meta, so I wouldn't recommend playing the counter trap. And for consistency, one terraforming, 3 Pot of Prosperity, and 2 Pot of Extravagance. The logic behind this is you want to open one of them. Of course, they conflict with one another, but having 5 of one card you want to open is the best ratio to open them. And then I also like, I play 3 Duality. Yeah, so 8 pots for consistency, you just need it in this deck. Then the best non-engine card, so the next 10 cards are the 10 non-engine slots, and the best by far is Libro de la Luna, which is like, it's amazing. It's going first crazy, it's going second crazy, you can do so much stuff with this card, it's amazing. Then I played 3 Book of Eclipse, which were okay, but in hindsight I would have rather played Ash, because this card isn't that great. It's okay. In this deck, it's okay. But this flips everything face up in defense position. If you cannot out them, if your opponent stops you, they draw a lot of cards. They're, like I said, in defense position, so Empen doesn't do anything against them. And also it's like Ashable, and your Branded matchup isn't that great. I didn't expect a lot of Branded, but I played once against Branded and I lost to Branded yesterday. And in hindsight, I should have played like Ashes probably, because Ashes still is really, really good. So this should have been Ashes. And then I thought about this card one day before the region, and I thought this might be a very good card. Is and turned out to be at the sales ban. So prior to this format, where Wind Statue was still a thing, I played Lances because for this spot, because Forbidden Lance is a really, really good card if you don't know if you go going second or first or second. And because you protect your Wind Statue and everything, basically the same thing Kestrel does now with Rysard. But Sales Band is really, really good in this deck as a like a going first and a going second card. Because going first, you can snipe the hand trap you're most afraid of. So with Droll running in the main decks, you can call Droll a lot if you can play. Because with your engine now, since you don't go for the Wind Statue, you can go more for engine. So most like a lot of times you can do Empen twice in one turn. So if you're not afraid of a single Ash or Imperm, you can just call Droll and be completely safe and play through any interruption, basically. If you have like a worse hand where you lose to one Imperm, let's say, then you can just call Imperm and you hope that they don't have Droll. Going second, this card is really, really good. The funny thing is, Nesh, I think, made a video yesterday about this card where he also said that it's quite good in certain decks, and it is in this deck because against Kestrel, you can just call a Rysard, and then a Rysard just becomes a macro, which is totally fine in Floowandereeze. So this is really, really good. And against Sprite, it's a 1-for-1 trade. You can also call the, if they play the Melfi variant, you can call like the little Melfi that bounces back and searches. I think it's the kitty cat or something like that. And against Mathmic, this card is also really, really, really good because you start, they have super factorial set and you just call a Laplacian with this card. And then they can basically, this card outs Laplacian right away because they cannot use its effect this turn. And against like a lot of decks, it's really, really good. And also like a really good as a 1-for-1 trade, and you, in the late game is also really, really nice because if you can read what your opponent wants to do or has on their hand or something, this card is really, really nice. Yesterday also there was a situation where I knew that my opponent must have an Ash in hand, and it was crazy. It was really, really good. And the last card play was Called by the Grave. I think this card is a little bit slept on. I think it's okay. I think it was fine yesterday. It wasn't like super duper good, but it was okay. Yeah, it outs like Droll, it outs any hand trap. Against Branded, it's good. Even against Kasher and Sprite, it's fine. They have oftentimes the same things that they have on the field in their grave. So you can hit something in the grave and out that on the field. It's for two turns negated. It was quite decent. Then for the extra deck, play whatever. The only important cards, like, play this. This is funny. And I actually made this yesterday against Matura Runic when they had Baguska. But the rest is totally irrelevant. And then for the side deck, so I needed to cover like Kestrel, Sprite, Branded, the Natura deck, the Labyrinth deck, or Trap Jakes, and Mathmic. I hope I don't forget something. So I played Shifter. This is against Mathmic and against Branded, and also if I think my opponent plays Droll a lot. So against Sprite, it's also okay, but it's mainly to have like seven cards going first against Droll. So you have Salesman, Called By, and Shifter. Then, because I respected the Sprite matchup, I expected so much Sprite, I played Dark Ruler No More, which is really, really good against Sprite. It basically outs the entire board, and then you can play on from there. Every time I drew this card yesterday, it was totally clutch. I won, I think, every game I saw this card. Then I accepted my fate against Anti-Spell and didn't play Cosmix because I needed more cards against like back row decks. So I played this. Uh, I I didn't play against Becker yesterday, but yeah, they were in there. Then I played three evenly matched. This is the best card basically going second. I said it, I think, going second at, I think, in every game. And yeah, it's really, really good. And for the last card, my going first card was three Solemn Judgments. You might ask, why didn't I play the Harpies card? The Harpies card is good, yeah, but it only like semi skips a turn. Castrate can still play a little bit, and yeah. So in other decks also, like they can play a tiny bit out your, like with board breakers out your entire board, and then it's hard for you to come back because they have like stuff on the field, like leaving just a Fenrir or something. If they have like Fenrir Birth and stuff like that, it hurts quite a lot. So I thought about Anti-Speller this card, and Anti-Spell is also a good card. However, I felt like Judgment is a little bit more versatile because it outs also evenly matched, which came up yesterday. So I was happy that I played this card. And also it's quite good to negate summons sometimes against Kestrel and against Sprite. It's overall just a really, really good card. So I played this one, and I didn't miss Anti-Spell, and I didn't miss the Harpies card. So yeah, this was the deck profile. I hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, I don't think it's the best deck, but it's really fun to play. And if you want to see like a combo tutorial or see what the engine can do, let me know in the comments. Until next time, guys. Bye-bye.